What's up, guys? We've got Jordan here from the Dimsy Project. You can find him on YouTube at the Dimsy Project. We're going to be taking a look at our toolkits today. He's got an adventurer's toolkit for a lot bigger bike, and it's pretty much an around-the-world kit. He's going to show you just about everything you're going to need to go across the country and into other countries and just about anything you want to do, all the tools that you're going to need. And then I'm going to show you more of a close-to-home, backyard type of toolkit on a smaller dual sport bike, so stay tuned for that.
All right, so you can see laid out in this large area is everything that I carry on my KLR 650. Now, most of this stuff is on my bike at all times. Some of this stuff is not, but I'm getting ready to go across the United States, so I'm carrying a lot of extra stuff that I may or may not need, but I'm gonna have it if I need it. All right, so I'm gonna start out with my basic hand tools here. Now, this is actually a fender pack. I don't carry it on my fender because it weighs so much. But inside my toolkit is pretty much everything I'm going to need to fix my bike in pretty much any situation. Alright, so I'm going to start on the left side of my toolkit here. I've got your basic size of wrenches. I have 8, 10, and 12 here, and a 14 and 17 millimeter over here. Next to that, I have 3 screwdriver bits. 2 of these are my factory KLR 650 toolkit, and one of these is a flathead that I had to make. Up next is my pliers. I have just my regular toolkit pliers, a set of vice grips. Next to those, I have an assortment of star bits. I carry 2 different size punches. This is mostly for chain repair or whatever you can use a punch for. The factory spark plug tool along with the screwdriver adapter on the end of it there. Up here, I have some hemostats. These lock together. Can hold something small, washers, just whatever you need to hold. I have a large adjustable wrench. The reason there's holes in it is just to reduce as much weight as I can where I can. I use this for my rear axle nut. I know a lot of people don't like these. Just be careful with it and they work good. I also carry a magnetic pickup tool, a small permanent marker. I also carry just a little shop towel to wipe surfaces down or clean my hands with. Now on the other side of my toolkit, I carry some hand cleaner. I also carry a small pick. I carry an assortment of Allen wrenches. These are all metric, just completely random sizes. Here I have a hammer that has been cut down, again to reduce weight, mostly for chain repair again. Not that I break chains a lot, but you never know, especially with the kind of weight that I'll be carrying. I have a small screwdriver here. It's got a Phillips and a flathead. This is mostly used for carburetor adjustments, going up in altitude or down at sea level. Here is a large assortment of zip ties, all different lengths. In this little pocket here, I have a couple hacksaw blades along with a couple metal files. Here I have a 3-inch and a 6-inch quarter-inch drive extension, along with a adjustable quarter-inch drive T-handle. I carry, again, the basic sizes in the quarter inch sockets, 8, 10, 12, and 14 millimeter, along with a U-joint swivel, which is very useful in some bikes. I carry a little bit of Gorilla tape, a small thing of anti-seize, a cable lube tool, and a couple little pieces of various grit sandpaper. And also in my tank bag, I do carry a flashlight. Alright, next I'm going to show you some emergency items that I carry. This is worst case scenario type items. So back here, I have an extra throttle cable for my bike. I do carry an extra clutch cable. It's currently attached and beside my working clutch cable, so I didn't want to take it off, but it is on my bike. I do carry an extra spark plug. Pretty much worthless nowadays, but you never know if you break one or something silly happens. This is something new I got. I haven't tried this. This is a self-sealing or self-adhering tape. This stuff is non-sticky. It only adheres to itself. I've seen people use this to repair radiator hoses and things like that on the trail. So hopefully I never have to use it, but it's something really cool that I carry along with me. In this bag, I carry a little bit of wire along with some random nuts and bolts. I carry this plastic radiator hose splice just in case it gets real bad. I carry an extra fuel filter along with some small clamps. I carry some JB Weld Quick along with a JB Weld Quick Steel stick. If you puncture a hole in your case too big, of course JB Weld's runny, so basically make a backing piece with your stick. I carry some RTV silicone. This stuff makes its own gasket. It's a super awesome adhesive in case something breaks. Plastic wise, this stuff's really, really strong. And of course, with the KLR650, you have to have Loctite. I have a random assortment of O-rings. And this one here, there's just electrical connectors, a little bit of wire. There's some electrical tape, a little bit of thread tape, along with some more Gorilla tape. This here is something I carry for my bike. It's pretty notorious for breaking off, and this goes around my choke lever. It's made of plastic that threads into the aluminum body of the carburetor. It's just, again, something that is broken easily in my bike, and I don't want to be somewhere and break that. Of course, I carry an assortment of fuses. The good thing about these small fuses is they also work in the large ones. I also carry an old piece of chain, along with two master links. These here are just old strap pieces in case I fall off halfway up a cliff or something and somebody can at least have something to pull me out with. This is something I probably shouldn't carry, but I do. This is just a whole extra headlight. It's an LED headlight, and I have two brake light bulbs in here just in case one breaks in the journey. And this here is just a little bit of gasket material. I really don't know why I carry it, but I do. So next up is my tire repair. I carry some of these in my toolkit. These are the Motion Pro Bead Pros. These can break the tire bead easily, along with having tire spoons. They're really lightweight. You can buy steel ones, but I went for the lightweight aluminums. Up next is my tube repair kit. I have some of these bicycle scabs. They're supposed to require no glue. I don't know if they work, but they're in there. Valve core tool and other patches with glue that I should probably replace before I take off. I also carry this for my fellow rider. This is a plug kit for a tubeless tire. Completely worthless to me, but maybe not to somebody else. I carry this 12 volt inflator. I did a review on this on my channel not long ago. Since then I've used it quite a bit and I absolutely love it. It has yet to let me down. To back that up, I do carry a hand pump for a bicycle. This will work. I've used it in the field. It takes right around 5 minutes to air up a 17 inch rear tire. Alright, I also carry tubes with me. I carry a rear 17 inch tube along with a new rim strip. I also carry a 21 with a rim strip. Seating the bead on a tire is a pain in the butt, as well as sometimes getting the actual tire on and off, so I carry this bottle of soapy water with me. Alright, so the last item I carry for tire repair is the crutch leg here. I can stick this underneath my foot peg if I need to pull my rear tire, or I can put this underneath my skid plate to pull my front tire because I don't have a center stand on my bike, and sometimes using a large rock or piece of wood isn't accessible, so I carry this lightweight guy here. And the last things that I carry when I go on long trips: foam filter oil, especially if I ride off road. That thing gets dirty really quick. I also carry a quart of oil, along with some chain wax. Okay, so that's everything I carry. Now let's see how much stuff Keith carries.
All right, so my kit's a little bit more simpler, so we'll just start with the tools first. All right, so in my Wolfman toolkit here, pretty simple. I just carry an air check tool, which I carry one of my tank bag just to get to quicker. I carry a couple lightweight wrenches. I got a 14 and a 12 double-ended wrench. I have an 8 and a 10 double-ended wrench, lightweight. And then I carry a spanner wrench. And then I also have axle wrenches that came stock with the bike. And then also the extension for that. And then we've got the spark plug wrench, which just connects to this. And then I can reach up under my frame because the DRZ is very tight to get to the spark plug. And then I carry one of these that just has an adapter in here for two different sizes of Phillips and two different sizes of flatheads. And then I carry a T-handle wrench with some Gorilla tape wrapped around it and also electrical tape. And then I also carry all the sockets as well as another Phillips bit on there. And then I've got various sizes of Allen wrenches, which I've checked the bike, and this is every Allen wrench that I will need for my bike. And then in here I also carry an extension for my tool here, a little bit of sandpaper, and some zip ties, and that's pretty much my entire toolkit. And then to kind of add to that, which kind of just basic chain kit here, we've got a couple chain links in this pocket, and we've got the chain breaker and the chain press right here. And this is all lightweight type of titanium here. Huh. And then we've got all the little bits and bobs to press or remove the chain.
I think I should probably buy that because I have a file and a hammer and a punch, and that would delete a lot of my weight.
Yeah. That's a little kit.
It is.
All right, now we'll kind of move on to the tire changing kit. Of course, I keep a couple extra bits and bobs in here, but I run these Motion Pro bead pros that have the breakers on one end and the spoons on the other. And they are lightweight titanium. And then I also carry an extra spark plug, just in case, just because I like the little container. It's pretty sweet. And carry a little bit more sandpaper, a couple different types there. A little bit of wire, clutch cable / throttle cable repair kit. And this is just the inside wire. You don't have any of the cabling, so you can just run it through there. And then it's got universal heads that you can mount on either end. A lighter, just because you never know. And then inside this pocket, just kind of strewn about in here, I keep miscellaneous nuts, bolts, and a fuel hose clamp. And then in this other pocket on the other side, this is my basic tube repair kit. Got a little bit of rubber cement, valve core stem remover, a little bit of blue Loctite, and some patches in there on top of the rubber. And then we've also got a valve stem puller. That way, you don't bloody your knuckles on the trail trying to get your valve stem pulled through your rim when you're changing a tube. And then inside the main compartment here, we've got your basic hand pump, which these work really well. You can actually set the bead with these if you've got a little bit of soapy water, which I do carry just a small thing of soapy water here. And then we've got your rim protectors on the trail so you don't beat up your rims. These are just super lightweight and they don't take up much room, so it's kind of nice to have them. And then I just carry a 121 inch front tube. That way, if you need it, you can repair your rear tube as well. And that's basically it for my kit. This is, like I said, a backyard kit. You can pretty much go wherever around, you know, your state, and you don't have to really worry about a lot because you're going to be within cell phone range of a lot of stuff. So that's basically it. And I can fit this all in about a carrying case about this big. And that's it. All right, guys, so hopefully you enjoyed that. Remember to check out the Dimsy Project right here on YouTube. Thanks for watching.